It's Southland Conference basketball on ESPN. A critical matchup this afternoon in Huntsville, Texas. Sam Houston State hosting Central Arkansas. And look at the Southland Conference standings. These teams separated by just one game. Central Arkansas would hold the tiebreaker with a win today. Both teams vying for the top four, which produces a bye in the first round of the conference tournaments. Welcome courtside, Matt Peterson with Ken Holland. And Ken, I think today we're really expecting offense from both these teams.
Yes, the last time out, 89-82, high-scoring ball game. Both teams could hit three-pointers, also drive into the lane. It's going to be interesting to see what breaks here today.
Both coaches with different priorities today. For Jason Noon, over a decade at the helm, his keys are transition and defending the three-point line. Meanwhile, a different look for Anthony Boone, his priorities as the interim head coach for Central Arkansas.
Well, I think Coach Boone and Central Arkansas, they want to limit the turnovers. The Bearcats do a great job of forcing turnovers, so they need to limit those and keep that down tonight to have a chance to be in this ballgame.
And out to our HEB, no player does more. Players to watch, beginning with DeAndre Jones of Central Arkansas.
DeAndre Jones, the 5'11 junior. Coach Boone really is impressed with how he manages the game. He does it really well. He's going to need to be able to do that on the offensive side tonight.
And for Sam Houston State, Zach Nuttall.
Zach Nuttall, he's the sophomore sensation. 23 points per game average last three games out. He had a double last Wednesday, getting a lot of rebounds, being an impact player on both sides of the court.
HEB, the official grocer of the Sam Houston State Bearcats and the Bearcats Sports Network. Here's the starting five presented by Miller Lite. For Central Arkansas, under associate head coach Anthony Boone, Ferguson, Kyalud, Koval, Baker, and DeAndre Jones. A lot of continuity in the Central Arkansas team. Trying to make a late run here in the Southland Conference and be a player in the conference tournament.
Yeah, they're sitting right there in the middle of the pack. They obviously need to win games down the stretch to be able to get in the conference tournament.
They've won four of their last five. 5-point victory over UNO on Wednesday, an overtime victory at McNeese last weekend. They lost at Lamar, but before that, wins over Southeastern Louisiana and Northwestern State. For Sam Houston State, they lost three in a row. At home to SFA, on the road at UIW and Nichols. Really tough overtime loss at UIW. They had a 4-point lead in overtime, but couldn't hang on. 6-point loss at Nichols, but they bounced back. 79-70 win at Southeastern Louisiana on Wednesday night.
Yeah, it was a good road win to finish that road trip. Obviously, they need to come back home and carry that momentum forward, have a big win tonight to set themselves up to down the stretch in the conference.
Miller Lite starting five for the Bearcats. RJ Smith, Chad Bowie, Zach Nuttall, Danen Swoop, and Kai Mitchell. Familiar starting five. A lot of experience in this group. Nuttall is the only underclassman, the sophomore from Bryan College Station.
Obviously, Zach Nuttall, the impact player of the game we mentioned earlier, leading scorer at 15 points a game. He's going to be a big part of what happens offensively. Like I said, he's also been showing up. Coach Hooten really challenges those offensive players to go get rebounds, and he's been doing that as of late.
Nuttall, 11 rebounds to go with 18 points, and Coach Hooten really believes that when he is rebounding, it sets up all the other facets of his game.
Absolutely. You know, whether they're offensive or defensive rebounds, once that ball gets in his hands, he's able to either fast break down, get it to one of his teammates. Zach just is able to create things when the ball's in his hands.
'89-'82 Central Arkansas win in Conway back on January 11th. Now the Bearcats really good from deep, 8 of 16 from three-point range. They shot 54% overall from the field in the win on Wednesday night in Hammond. A run Russ Pennell, sixth-year head coach. A lot of experience before Central Arkansas, but stepped away. Anthony Boone has called it a weird situation, stepping in for his former boss, but he's gone 8-8 since taking over. Central Arkansas, a very talented team, a lot of size. Trying to get over the hump here in 2020. Seven-footer Haven Koval will go up against Kai Mitchell of the Bearcats. Koval taps it right to Chad Bowie, and the Bearcats have the first possession. Danen Swoop. Bounce pass inside to Mitchell. Mitchell spinning on Koval. Mitchell from 10 feet. Bearcats score first.
Kai Mitchell likes that shot, that range. It's comfortable for him. We may see a lot of that tonight.
Coach Boone said the Bearcats must handle the pressure of Sam Houston State right off the bat. You don't oftentimes see that. That's big man on big man, center on center. Mitchell guarding Koval tightly, 30 feet from the basket.
Yeah, you see that underneath the paint, but not out in the open very often.
Here's Swoop, grad transfer from Elon University, native of Overland Park, Kansas. Now RJ Smith back for Chad Bowie. Bowie back for Swoop from the corner, in and out. Smith tapped it, Bowie retrieves it, left it long. Another offensive board, Mitchell off the back rim. And then a foul by Smith as he went for another offensive board.
A lot of activity underneath the basket. That ball just not going in the bucket. I think there were three or four rebounds on that one possession.
Chad Bowie guarding DeAndre Jones. They left it there, almost a misdirection there as it went right past Baker and laid up and in. We're tied at two. Ryan Bergerson, the leading scorer, 15 points per game with the layup there. Hard feed inside. Smith took a dribble, had it turned away. Bowie couldn't grab it. Here come the Bears, 3-on-3. Bergerson, Koval. Cleans it up. A lot of size on this team. Bergerson, 6'6", number one. Eddie Kyalu, number 13, is 6'7". Hayden Koval, 7-footer. The big man, number 15, inside. Here's Bowie. Got in the air, out to Danen Swoop. Mitchell from deep. He's getting better and better from downtown this season.
He likes those shots. If he gets hot, he may go out there quite often.
Offensive foul, Bergerson with the push off. Good defense from Zach Nuttall.
You know, the Sam Houston State Bearcats are known for being a three-point shooting team. Both of their big men can go out beyond the arc and knock them down.
Last year were spectacular. They averaged 9.5 made threes per game last year when they won the conference title. Stop and go from Zach Nuttall, and he finishes ahead of Koval. Inside. Good touch on the inside. Eddie Kyalu, native of Paris, France. Came to the U.S., went to the Oak Hill Academy. Sophomore, big man. Nuttall misses the deep three. Good start to this game. Bearcats up a point. Kyalu flying forward, missed the layup. Nuttall with the rebound. Out to Bowie. Bowie driving. Tough angle, and it rolls off the rim. Real scrap for the rebound. He feeds it to Mitchell. He's fouled by Kyalu. Eddie Kyalu, 6'7". Good intensity to this game, just 3 minutes in.
Yeah, both teams driving into the lane, making those shots, and drawing some fouls as well.
Now Mitchell at the line. He made the three. He's been very selective when shooting the three, as we see the foul on Kyler. Did not attempt one on the three-game road swing, but 1-for-1 against SFA at home, 1-for-2 against Abilene Christian, 1-for-1 against Lamar on the road. So become a better three-point shooter. His season average 29%, but as of late, making about 50% of his attempted threes.
I think the pre-conference games, he probably shot more three-pointers, but once conference started, he was a little more selective when the opportunities arose, and he's just been draining them.
Good change of pace from Kyalute, who finishes off the right window. 8-8. Bowie, swoop. Not all in for Mitchell. Mitchell, forced the feed inside for Smith, plus the foul. 2 on Kyalute here in the first 3.5 minutes.
Good job by the Bearcats getting the ball in the lane with traffic. Kylo just came over across the back of R.J. Smith, and as he was going up for the shot.
Well, Kylo made it look easy on the offensive end a moment ago, averaging 12 points per game, but early foul trouble, 2 points, or 2 fouls committed in less than 4 minutes. Now Smith misses the free throw. Jared Chatham, a junior from Los Angeles, into the game, wearing number 34. Inside for Koval. Nuttall fell down. Koval finishes. He has 6 points early on. Danen swoop. High screen Mitchell. Bowie for swoop, and now Nuttall. Nuttall put back from Smith. Behind the back dribbling here from DeAndre Jones. Jones falling down. He nearly scored. He thought he was fouled. Good feed. Mitchell over the top for swoop. Up and under, and a finish for swoop. R.J. Smith had the putback dunk. Coach Hooten all season has called him the X Factor. When he can score and rebound, they often win.
Well, what R.J. Smith, he put himself in a great position for the rebound, and it just so happened that he could slam it home.
Nuttall with the rebound. Entry fast for Mitchell. He got Koval in the air. Great balance in the air and finish off the window for Mitchell. He hung in the air a long time, adjusted his body well. Chatham inside. Contested shot missed by Jackson Baker. Up tempo for both teams here in the first half. Left wing three is there for Nuttall. Timeout, Central Arkansas. It's a 9-0 run for the Bearcats in just over a minute. Cats up 9 here in the first half.
All right, who's up first?
Oops,
next. H-E-B, creations are creamy and have like 1905 flavors. Not quite.
Chocolate caliente mexicano de creamy creation.
So close.
It's good.
H-E-B creamy creations is how Texas does ice cream.
It's good.
Whether we're ready for it or not, life happens. Sometimes it knocks us down. Sometimes it takes the legs right.
Welcome back. A 9-0 run for the Cats before the timeout. 8 for Mitchell. 5 for Nuttall. The Bearcats have already attempted 15 shots in just over 5 minutes. Remarkable pace.
Yeah, they came. Both teams came out running. Seems like this is just going to be a fast-paced game, up and down.
Full court press from the Bearcats. Aaron Wiedenar, number 3, into the game. Koval comes out. Top of the key for Chatham. Working on Smith. Missed it. Central Arkansas will retain possession.
Matt, it's going to be interesting to watch the matchups between the big men on both teams. Obviously, Central Arkansas has a lot of height. Mark Tikanico checks in the game. He's the tallest player for the Sam Houston State Bearcats, but most of the four or five guys for Sam Houston, not that tall. Be interesting to watch that through the course of the game.
Central Arkansas has missed its last five from the field. Chatham missed that three. Here's Nuttall flying to the basket, rejected by Koval. Bearcats will inbound with 15 left on the shot clock. Cyrus Johnson will check in for the Bearcats. RJ Smith goes to the bench. Ryan Bergerson departs for Central Arkansas. Here's Nuttall, a deep two. Seven for Nuttall. It's an 11-0 run for Sam Houston State. Widener on the right wing, inside, traveling the call against Jared Chatham. Full court press here from the Bears. Danen Swoop. We'll push it forward. 6 foot guard, grad transfer. And a Kansas native, Nuttall. Down the baseline, Swoop. Good feed inside. That was half a shot, half a pass. Now Nuttall from the corner. Bearcats on fire from deep. 3 of 5 from downtown.
I don't think Cyrus Johnson was ready for that pass. I think he was expecting the three-point shot from Danen Swoop.
Yeah, in midair, I think Swoop changed his mind instead of a shot, fed it inside to Johnson. 14 unanswered points for Sam Houston State. Koval with the high screen. Jones back for Koval. Tikonico, nice closeout. 5 to shoot. Jones. He got it off. He missed it. And an offensive rebound from Colin Cooper. Now Jones. Soft pass for Koval. Tikonico stood him up. And a foul. Who's this on? I think it's on Tikonico.
Yeah, it is.
A very late whistle.
It was a late whistle. I thought Mark Tikonico did a great job of staying on the floor, didn't get his feet up, just stood there. I think since Koval went to the floor, maybe they thought there was some kind of contact there.
Koval goes to the free throw line. Associate head coach and interim head coach Anthony Boone says Koval has always been a presence on the glass with rebounding, always in a good position. And a very good grades and accounting major, Koval, out of Prosper, Texas, went to Linkier Prep. DeMarcus Lampley comes in for the Bearcats. Nuttall gets a break. Those free throws ended a 14-0 run. Cross court. Lampley, bounce pass, Tikonico. Swoop. Hands it off for Johnson. Lampley for Swoop, four to shoot. Swoop. Running floater. Johnson with the offensive rebound. Left it short on the putback. Might be an opportunity for Johnson to get some extended playing time against his big Bear team. Corner three right there from Aaron Widener.
First field goal that the Bears have made in quite a long time.
Bowie with the fadeaway, his first 2 points. Out to the corner, contested three. Rebounded by Bowie. The miss from Colin Cooper. Lampley, swoop from the corner. Off the side of the backboard. Rebound pulled in by Chatham. Now this game, not yet 9 minutes old. The Bearcats have attempted 22 shots. Jones, good recovery, but he missed the layup. Tico Nico taps the rebound to Swoop. Swoop for Johnson. Moving screen on Johnson. Under 12 minute media timeout. Bearcats up 12 here against Central Arkansas.
How'd you find it?
.10:58 left first half, Bearcats up 12. Matt Peterson with Ken Holland. A great pace to this game, an NBA feel to it. Both teams pushing the tempo. Eddie Kyalud back on the floor playing with two fouls. He picked up two in less than 4 minutes to start this game. Something to watch here in the middle stages of the first half. Bergerson lost his footing, went down in the paint. Out to Smith. Missed three, then some bodies flying underneath. I believe it's just Bearcat basketball after it went over the backboard. Loose ball foul against Aaron Widener. Corner three for Lampley off the back rim. They're fighting for it. That one intended for Ken Holland. Now Lampley will inbound. Tico Nico goes to the bench. Kai Mitchell returns. Bearcats have out-rebounded the Bears 12-8. Both teams 10 points in the paint. Xavier Bryant into the game, sophomore from DeSoto, Texas. He'll run the offense here. Entry pass for Mitchell. Good ball movement here from the Cats. DeJuan Jones. Jones back for Bryant. Bryant stepped back, missed it. Johnson nearly got the offensive rebound. He'll be called for the reach in as he went for the loose ball against Widener. Second on Cyrus Johnson. A good size for Johnson, the freshman from Culver City High School. 6'5", 220 pounds.
Cyrus Johnson has a tremendous upside at this level. Obviously, he's getting playing time as a freshman.
SK inside, great feed for Kyalud, who has two more. SK from Rogers, Arkansas. SK Shitsu, 6'9", sophomore. Bounce pass inside, kicked out. Lampley streaking to the basket, he missed it. SK pulls in the rebound. Too quick for the Bears. That was too far in front of Widener. Johnson and Lampley go to the bench. Nuttall and Smith return for the Cats. Full court pressure from the Bears. Widener goes to the bench. DeAndre Jones returns for Anthony Boone and the Bears. Nuttall, they're going to try to trap in the backcourt. Xavier Bryant.
Almost has a feeling like we're in the second half with this full court pressure.
Both teams going cold here midway through the first half. Turnaround for Mitchell. 10 points for Mitchell. 4 of 5 from the field.
For a big man, he has a great finesse around the basket. Soft touch.
Chatham had it stolen. DeJuan Jones stripped him, and a great feed to the corner there for Xavier Bryant. Bryant, great shake and bake back to Jones for three. He missed it. Rebound pulled in by SK Shitsu. Shitsu from Nigeria. Left side, Bergerson. Defended by Nuttall. DeAndre Jones pulls it out. Junior from Boise, Idaho. Mitchell came flying out. Good body control. Very easily could have been a blocking foul. But you saw Mitchell shuffle the feet to stay out of the way. Fifth foul against the Bearcats, first on Xavier Bryant. Jackson Baker returns, the junior from Los Angeles. Kyalu kicks it out, Koval. Good hands in the passing lane from Xavier Bryant. Media timeout, Bearcats up 12 in Huntsville.
Since 1879, students have come from far and wide to a place unlike any other, a place where tradition runs deep, honor holds special meaning, and orange brings us together. It's a place where friendships are formed and futures take shape. Every day, students discover Sam Houston anew and walk across our stage, united as alumni, united as Bearcats. Join the Alumni Association today.
Hey, we're here with Texans quarterback Deshaun Watson to prove that HEB Texas Tough Trash Bags can handle anything you throw at them. You ready?
I'm ready. Can you back up for me?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Ooh, see if you can put a hole in it. Throw it even harder. There you have it. They aren't just tough.
They're Texans tough. I think I can throw a little bit harder.
Wow, I felt some heat on that.
Ooh, my bad, Scott.
What?
HEB Texas Tough. Tough enough for the toughest you've got.
Entertaining start to this one. Matt Peterson with Ken Hall, and the Bearcats are up by 12.
And it doesn't really seem like that it's that big of a lead. These teams are just playing back and forth. Obviously, the Bears have had 6 or 5 turnovers so far that's led into some more points for the Bearcats.
Koval makes the three. It was a closeout from Bowie. Nice play design for Central Arkansas. That was a key for Jason Hooten, was defending the three-point line. They had the undersized Bowie against the 7-footer Koval. Bears now 2 of 6 from deep. Bryant to the corner for Smith. Missed it. Kyalud pulls in the rebound. Well, Kyalud, dangerous pass, nearly stolen. Recycled to the corner, short from Baker. Here comes Bowie in transition. Inside for Smith. Bryant. What a pass for Mitchell. I thought he might get rejected, but he fed it to Mitchell instead.
Yeah, fed it to Mitchell, who was able to have the body up and in. And great job by Bryant.
12 points for Mitchell, 5 of 6 shooting. Baker with the charge. Jason Hooten fired up. You can see him middle of the screen coming over to celebrate his defense.
Well, Coach Hooten, he prides his teams on defense, and so when he sees a play like that, he gets really excited.
It's very interesting, the Bearcats, as the referees talk it over. They're going to look at the monitor. It's hard to really get a feel for this Bearcat defense and how good they are statistically. And the charge drawn there by Xavier Bryant. Now, points allowed per game, 72 points per game for the Bearcats. I would say that's below average, maybe middle of the road for the Southland Conference. But they have some numbers that lead to transition. And the refs are going to give us an explanation. It's going to call a double foul, a flop called on Xavier Bryant. Not a call you see too often in college basketball.
Is that before? I didn't catch where that happened.
Well, I think the rule is you can take a charge, but if you flop, it can somehow be a foul on the defensive player. A double foul. Mitchell with two more. He's on fire. 14 points, 6 of 7 from the field. Jones back in it out. Fouled on the outside before the shot.
Matt, I'm still confused by that. I need some help. I don't understand. If you take a charge, it's either you take a charge or you have a flop, one or the other.
Here's Bergerson. Quiet start for him. He's the leading scorer. Out to DeAndre Jones. Good ball fake. And a foul on the outside. RJ Smith, his second foul.
I think there's a little discussion on why that's a shooting foul. Well, I guess we're in the bonus, so.
Jones makes the free throw. Terriante Thomas returns. So does Danen Swoop. Bergerson goes to the bench for Central Arkansas. The flop rule is 4-10.1. Tot C4, and the NCAA's directive is to get rid of flopping. Now Gavitt, who is part of the rules committee for the NCAA, made it clear they want to get it out of the game. Corner three for Bowie, that's long. Rebounded by Chatham. Out to Baker, stolen. Here comes Bowie behind the back. Bowie. Top of the key for Mitchell, another three. 17 points for Kai Mitchell here in the first half. Cross court, Baker. And there's a charge. Excellent defense from Nuttall, who high fives his head coach, Jason Hooten.
No flopping on that charge. Matt, over here on this side where Kai Mitchell made that three-pointer, three passes to get it to Kai Mitchell to step out and hit that three-pointer.
More on this flop rule. It's used to identify faking a play, likely on a block, charge, three-point shot, or any other tactic to fool the official. Mitchell grabs a loose ball. He has 19 points. Stolen by Bowie. Mitchell fouled on his way up to dunk. Bearcats are flying. Central Arkansas with three timeouts left. I'm a bit surprised they haven't used one here. The Bearcats are just rolling here in the first half, up by 16.
They are playing with a high level of energy in this game. I think that coming back home after their long road trip, wanted to get out to a positive start in this half, and that's what they've been doing.
Mitchell misses the first free throw. Bearcats shooting 47% as a team. Bearcats have been so good in transition. The guards have gotten the ball and had intensity to get up court on every possession. Bergerson has not gotten going at all. 2 points on two shots. He's averaging 15 points per game. Where's number one for Central Arkansas? Now it's Jones. Knocked away from behind by Bowie, nearly retrieved by Mitchell. Koval with the turnaround. Nice touch with five left on the shot clock.
Great job by Koval to just do a turnaround, a fadeaway jumper with two men on him.
Nice touch from Terriante Thomas, a transfer from East Mississippi Community College. Bearcats shooting 49%. Koval responds with a layup. He's got 14 on eight total shots. Central Arkansas coaches urging their team to get tighter on defense. Offensive rebound from Thomas after Nuttall's miss. Just hear the coaches screaming at the Central Arkansas players to get tighter. Extra step for Terriante Thomas. Media timeout in Huntsville. The Bearcats have led by 17. They lead by 15 here, closing in on halftime. Welcome back. Bearcats up by 15. Great explanation during the break between our officials, Doug George, Mike Thornton, and Kevin Rahr. It was not a flop called on Xavier Bryant. It was a warning given to him for a previous flop earlier in that sequence. It was a two-shot possession that time for Central Arkansas as Jones misses a wild layup, saved by Swoop to Bowie. We'll finish the thought on flopping in a second. Bowie kicks it out. Terriante Thomas short. Mitchell another rebound, and he's fouled. Mitchell back to the free throw line. So we were talking with the officials after reading the rule during a timeout. You get one warning for flopping, basically embellishment. The second time it's a technical, but you can have a flop called on a charge if you're misleading the ref into making the call.
Right.
But on that one, it was not a double foul. It was simply a charging foul on Jackson Baker of Central Arkansas.
We're watching the replay as we see how Kai Mitchell got fouled here. When I was watching the replay earlier, that foul, I noticed that Xavier Bryant got up off the floor right before and took that charge. So that's probably he probably did something, got on the floor, and that's what they were warning him about.
Yes. Koval from straight away knocks it down. 17 points for Koval. The centers, the stars of this first half. Mitchell missed it. Bergerson pulls in the rebound. Central Arkansas has made 5 of its last 7 from the field. Bergerson rejected by Mitchell. 2 blocks now for Mitchell, who has 21 of Sam Houston State's 41 tonight.
Koval has such a great shot from the three-point range, very fluid. And he's not even playing down in the paint right now. He's setting up.
Bergerson driving, lowers the shoulder. He draws a foul. Zach Nuttall whistle for the foul. It's his first.
So the Bearcats, I wasn't going to say anything. I didn't want to jinx them, but they just committed their first turnover of the game versus 9 for Central Arkansas.
That's excellent point. Great ball control for Jason Hooten's team. And I mentioned it earlier, but the game's at such a fast tempo, it's hard to make these larger points. This Bearcat defense allowing 72 points per game, but I think a lot of that has to do with the pace of their games. Other teams get more possessions because how quickly they play on offense.
Right.
Now Bergerson misses both, but they get the loose ball. Koval turned away by Mitchell, but that's a foul.
That's a foul on Kai Mitchell, but he had a lapse in judgment on that pass. He didn't like it, and he's like, no, you're not going to score on me on my mistake. So
the Bearcats allowing 72 points per game, but 5th in the country, turnovers forced, 19 per game, 7th in total steals, 235 as a team, 9th in steals per game, 10th in turnover margin, 11th in total steals. Amongst the best in the country in forcing turnovers and getting steals, but still allowing 72 points per game. So I think when you're high risk, high reward, maybe you go
Absolutely.
For a steal, leads to an easy bucket or a 3.
Right. And I think that's what's been so impressive so far tonight. We've been playing at a fast pace with only 2 turnovers for the Bearcats. Usually when you're playing at that pace, you have more than that.
Thomas for Mitchell, 23 points for Kai Mitchell.
Kai Mitchell is just flying all over the place tonight.
And that will count plus the foul. Central Arkansas up tempo down court. 3-point play opportunity coming here for Jared Chatham.
Nice pass from Terriante Thomas into Kai Mitchell for the finish there.
Mark Ticonico checks in. Mitchell goes to the bench with his 2 fouls. Chatham described as a hard worker. Coaches want him to stay more positive about himself. He's one to be down on himself after a mistake or a poor game. Gonna graduate this May. He'll have some decisions to make, grad school or a second degree at Central Arkansas for Jared Chatham. Now the Bears hanging around. They trail by as many as 17. They're down by 10. Nuttall, deep 2 over Koval.
And he had to get it over Koval. Koval had a long, outstretched arm that rainbowed it over him.
Nuttall with the dozen. Chatham. Guarded by Thomas. Kicks it out. Koval from the corner. Missed it. Bowie with the rebound. Almost fought Nuttall for it. Thomas. Drew the foul. DeAndre Jones commits the foul.
Thomas only making his 23rd trip to the line, but shooting 73% for the year.
Coach Hooten has always said he has flashes of brilliance. He's wanted him to find a niche and help the Bearcats get better. Getting some good run here, 5 minutes here in the first half off the bench. Makes both. Koval.
It's so strange seeing a seven-footer trailing and getting the ball at the top of the key.
Jones. Away from Nuttall. What a pass. Koval fouled by Tikonenko. Really risky pass from Jones. You see him sort of celebrating after.
Yeah, he liked that, didn't he?
He knew it was bold. Somehow split two defenders.
That was pretty.
Jones out of Linkier prep. Same with Hayden Koval. A pipeline from Linkier prep. Last year, Central Arkansas team had four players. Now Bergerson went there as well. San Branson, Missouri, excellent basketball school.
That was an interesting play. Koval went under there and hit the underneath of the basket.
Bubba Furlong checks in for the first time tonight. But Jones has become a key player on this year's team, and he was sort of lightly recruited by Central Arkansas. They were watching Linkier. They kept watching him, and after seeing him multiple times, they decided this guy can be a player for us, and they signed him. Jones averaging 14 points per game, missed three from Zach Nuttall. And a look from Hooten, he wasn't pleased with that shot from Zach Nuttall.
Yeah, I think Coach Hooten would have liked him to either make another pass or drive into the lane.
Points in the paint, an 18-16 advantage. Bowie knocks it away. Bergerson behind the back. Blocked by Furlong. Good help from Furlong. Bergerson turned away. A Hooten will call time. Love saving his timeout, so use one here. The use it or lose it variety here in the first half. And a couple games ago at home, there was more time left on the clock, but he called timeout 50 seconds left. The Bearcats got 2 3-pointers, and it stretched, I think, a 5-point lead to 11 before halftime. They went on to win.
Yeah, you always kind of wonder why not just, you know, go down and run the clock out, but I think, to your point, draw up a good play that takes the time off the clock, but if you can get a three-pointer to end the half, definitely a good swing to have.
And that was against Texas A&M Corpus Christi back at the end of January. Now Bearcats, just 2 turnovers. 12 assists on 19 made field goals, shooting 46% as a team. Central Arkansas shooting 43%. Bearcats a 20-15 rebound edge. 10 seconds left for the Cats here in the first half, up 13. Bowie. Swoop. And Thomas stepped out of bounds right in front of the Central Arkansas bench. 1.5 seconds left. Aaron Widener checks in for the final second and a half. To inbound the ball. Caught by Furlong from midcourt. Top of the backcourt. He's not in there to shoot, folks. 13-point lead for the Cats. Your thoughts, Ken Holland?
Well, what an explosive game by the Bearcats coming out. It's been a back-and-forth physical game, but obviously Bearcats have been able to turn turnovers into points and has the lead that they have going into halftime.
Koval, 20 points for Central Arkansas. Kai Mitchell, 23 points, 9 of 11 from the field to lead the Bearcats. Cats up 13 at halftime.
simple things. We take them for granted every day. Until a spine problem, brain tumor, ruptured brain aneurysm, or stroke makes even the effortless impossible. But here at CHI St. Luke's Health, the Woodlands Hospital, fast access to treatment and new interventional and surgical techniques are making the critical difference for patients and giving them back what matters most, the simple things.
Since 1879, students have come from far and wide to a place unlike any other, a place where tradition runs deep, honor holds special meaning, and orange brings us together. It's a place where friendships are formed and futures take shape. Every day, students discover Sam Houston anew and walk across our stage, united as alumni, united as Bearcats. Join the Alumni Association today.
Somebody went to HEB.
Oh yeah, I'm cooking HEB natural beef, chicken, and pork. That's perfect for the four of us.
I'm wondering what else is perfect for the four of us.
Today's the day I'm gonna get to play with my best friend.
Play one of my songs.
Scott, get out of my head.
HEB's natural meats, 100% natural. No antibiotics or added hormones ever.
The proud son of hardworking immigrant parents, Eric Rodas chose to serve his country. A father, a soldier, and now a college graduate. He proved that circumstances have nothing to do with your outcome. Since 1879, we've been helping students like Eric determine their future. Sam Houston State University, a great name in education. Third generation Bearcat, Tacy Webb, roped her way to a national championship through her hard work and fearless dedication. Trading her saddle for nursing scrubs, Tacy set her sights in another arena, a place where she can champion the needs of others. Since 1879, we've been helping students like Tacy reach their championship potential. Sam Houston State University, a great name in education.
Halftime in Huntsville, Texas. The Bearcats 47, Central Arkansas 34. Another game with the makings of a high-scoring affair. Both teams in the 80s in the prior meeting, January in Conway, a Central Arkansas victory. Now the upcoming schedule for Central Arkansas. At SFA on Wednesday. At home against Nichols. At Abilene Christian and Southeastern after that.
Yeah, a tough schedule for Central Arkansas, but obviously they have some teams at the top of the schedule that they're going to have to play. This is the time of the year that you have to win those type of games to position yourself for the tournament.
Top eight make the tournament. Top two get a double bye. Top four get a single bye. We look at those next couple. Nichols, 10-4 in second. Some tough games coming up for the Bears. 13-point lead for the Bearcats at halftime. Thank you. Halftime entertainment here in Huntsville, Texas at Johnson Coliseum. The Bearcats up by 13 over Central Arkansas, trying to avenge a loss in Conway. In fact, Central Arkansas won here late last season too. So the Bearcats trying to avoid a third straight loss to Central Arkansas. Now the upcoming schedule for Sam Houston State, presented by CHI St. Luke's Health Emergency Center. They'll host Lamar. Lamar's 7-8 on the season. That game is on Wednesday. And then home to Houston Baptist at Abilene Christian. And then at Texas A&M Corpus Christi and SFA. SFA atop the conference at 13-1. Texas A&M Corpus Christi is 6-8. Abilene Christian, the defending tournament champion for the Southland, 9-4. Ken Helen, what do you make of the final five games on the schedule?
Well, obviously, it's every time the Bearcats have an end of the season, they play SFA to end the season, so it's always going to be a tough matchup. But Abilene Christian, Texas A&M, Corpus Christi, always going to be tough opponents as well. They have their work cut out for them.
We'll come back with highlights and stats from the first half. The Bearcats, a 13-point lead behind 23 points from Kai Mitchell and 12 from Zach Nuttall. Welcome back, Johnson Coliseum. Bearcats up by 13 at halftime. And now a look at the highlights from the first half. Now the Bearcats slowed down Bergerson. The leading scorer only had 2 points. Those were them. But Koval was very good. 20 points, 7-10 from the field for Central Arkansas. Kai Mitchell, the star, 9-11 from the field.
Yeah, it's impressive watching both the big men, Koval for the Bears and Kai Mitchell for the Bearcats. They're having dominant performances on both ends of the court.
We saw Kailu there. He had early foul trouble, 2 fouls in the first 4 minutes. That slowed him down. There was RJ Smith. He also was slowed by foul trouble. He had 2 in the first half. But Nuttall flying through the air. Smith with the putback. Bearcats getting scoring up and down the roster, but Nuttall and Mitchell accounting for 35 of the 47 points.
Yeah, those two guys by themselves are pretty much carrying the team at this point. It'll be interesting to see who gets production in the second half.
We'll be back with the second half from Huntsville. The Bearcats trying to open up a two-game lead over Central Arkansas. 13-point lead at halftime. Set for the start of the second half here at Johnson Coliseum. Matt Peterson with Ken Holland. Bearcats led by 17 in that first half at 40-23. Only one lead for Central Arkansas early in the first half at 4-2. There we go. Central Arkansas in black, the Bearcats in white. Out to the corner for Kyle Lewin. Missed the three. Rebound pulled in by Chad Bowie. Here comes Danen Swoop. Both teams return with the same starting five. It's Bergerson, Kyle Lewin, Koval, Baker, and Jones for Central Arkansas. Mitchell from the right wing left it short. Baker with the rebound for Central Arkansas. Kyle Lewin ball fake. Missed the running layup, fights for it, somehow saved it. Excellent hustle from the Frenchman, Eddie Kailu. Jones for three, short. Mitchell rebounds. Now Danen Swoop. Nuttall. Shuffle the feet, Bowie travels. DeAndre Jones, just 2 points in the first half, 0 for 4. Chad Bowie, an excellent defender. He's been on him all night.
Yeah, Chad Bowie, That's his role this season, is the defensive stopper. He may have games.
Nuttall came for the double team. Will be called for a reach-in foul, second on Nuttall. Into Kyalute. Guarded by Smith, bounce pass into Baker. Baker nearly lost it, fouled on his way up.
Seemed like they let him play a little bit more in the first half, but they're gonna start calling some.
Baker, 6'7" out of Phoenix, Arizona. Went to Brophy Prep. Missed the first, made the second. Here's Bowie, decides to take the three. And this is where the Bearcat offense has sort of stagnated late in the first half and early in the second. Look at that move. Kyalute slaloming for the finish. Bearcats just settling for threes, it feels like.
Yeah, they really haven't got anything going just yet. A couple misses.
Mitchell inside for Smith.
And that was really their bread and butter in the first half, is going into the paint. They need to start doing that again.
Cats back up 12. Jones. Bergerson missed it. Koval tips the rebound to himself. Poked out. Pulled back in by Baker. He missed a good look. Put back plus a foul for Baker. Now Baker, the redshirt freshman. Thomas returns. Interim head coach Anthony Butte. We sometimes forget that he's just a redshirt freshman. Feels like a junior with his size. Completes the three-point play. Not the most athletic, always in the right position. Very personable, gets along with everybody on the team. Cats up 9. Swoop. Hands off for Bowie. Bowie, a deep 2. Kyalute clears the rebound. Jones, a pull-up 3. Missed it. Mitchell pulls in the deep rebound. Jones now 0-for-5 from the field. He's averaging 14 points per game. Typically a good shooter. 40% overall, 40% from downtown. Smith draws a foul underneath.
Had a mismatch down there. Jones for the Bears on RJ Smith. Got caught up and drew the foul.
Top of the key, it's Bowie. Dane and Swoop. RJ Smith, clear travel. I think so much of this offense for Sam Houston State depends on the rhythm and getting downhill and ball movement. I think a guy isolated on the wing driving to the basket is not what the Bearcats would like. There's a turnover, one by Thomas.
Yeah, it just seems like the halftime breaks gets them out of that rhythm. Then they got to get back in it.
Big shot there from Swoop. He's got 4 points. Kyalude had a tip, nearly 2 straight turnovers on inbound plays for Central Arkansas. And Kyalude says, I don't need to inbound these. He sprints to the front court. Smart decision.
He was looking around where his players were, and nobody was there. He finally got it in.
Baker into Kyalude. He flies forward. Nice touch with the left hand. He's got big size, but he can move. Eddie Kyalute.
Really, absolutely. Very impressive.
Runs like a guard. Moves like a guard. But interior player's body. Swoop fouled on the outside. Now Coach Anthony Boone raved about Kai Alert. Called him a great addition to the team. On the outside of Paris, wants to do everything well, not just as a basketball player, good student. Even when he's having a bad game, great teammate, cheering his teammates on from the bench. Interesting here, Jones goes to the bench. Ineffective tonight, 2 points. Conversation there with Anthony Boone, who himself played at Ole Miss. Now Widener returns for Jones. Another possession here for the Cats after the missed free throw from Swoop. Jason Hooten must be pleased. This Cats seeking their 10th win in conference play today. Would move to 10-5 with a victory today. We go to 17-9 overall. Alley-oop attempt for Smith. It was too low from Chad Bowie. Kyalud spinning in the paint. Bowie with the steal. Knocked it to Swoop. Out to Bowie. He'll lay it up and miss. Seemed to rush himself a little bit. He was peeking over his shoulder.
Yeah, he was trying to see who was behind him. That ball was just out in front of him and he didn't have body control.
Media timeout, it's a 10-point lead for Sam Houston State. Welcome back, Johnson Coliseum, Huntsville, Texas. Matt Peterson with Ken Holland. Back and forth, second half here. 8-5 Central Arkansas since halftime.
Yeah, the Bearcats really haven't been able to score like they were in the first half. We talked about the flow of the ball game. They need to get back in that flow here in the second half.
Mark Tikonico returns, the Russian. Top of the key, missed. Bowie with a good look from downtown. A forced pass inside, Bergerson out to the corner, and that's right there. Off the bench, Widener, his second three today.
Widener just was left open in the corner, knocked down that three-pointer.
Here's Smith. Bears within seven. Hands off to Bowie. Tikonico runs it down to midcourt. Bowie for Swoop from the right wing. Missed it. Cats now 0 for 4 from beyond the arc since halftime. Koval backs down Tikonico. Tikonico went for the steal. It's a reach in foul.
Tikonico's third foul. of the game, and now he and Kai Mitchell both have three.
Now Mitchell being out critical for the Cats. The entire offense went through him. He was a force in that first half. Hustling for everything. Kyle Uda pull up three, missed it. Swoop, good seal off for the rebound against the larger Ryan Bergerson. Tico Nico, entry pass for Smith. He'll face up against Kyle Uda. Koval helped out, force an adjustment from Smith. Another possession here for the Cats, who missed their last four shots. Dane and Swoop. Hands off for Smith. Eight to shoot. Dewan Jones. Corner to Thomas. He'll blast to the basket and get fouled. Tried the posterized dunk. Widener fouled him.
You know, the Bearcats were passing it around the corners, trying to pull everybody out. They finally did that. The big men were out on the edge, and Terriante was able to go in, and the only way to stop him was to foul him.
Thomas makes the first.
Striking in and had to come from way over to try to block that shot.
Bubba Furlong returns for the Cats. Mark Tico Nico to the bench. Bergerson also to the bench. Central Arkansas in some ways has to be pleased. They're down by only eight. Jones back in the game with 0 points. And Bergerson, their leading scorer for the season, has just 2 points. Offensive foul. Eddie Kailud called for the foul, his fourth.
You know, as you were talking about Kailud earlier, just in that he didn't think he had that foul, but he raised his hand. It's mine. You don't see that very often.
Yeah, especially a player who has three. That makes his fourth foul. Four fouls in 14 minutes for Kailu. If he could stay on the floor, I mean, he'd be a 20-point-per-game player based off his athleticism and skill set. Thomas, an extra step. And again, I think that's not the best Bearcat basketball. This is a talented team. Coach Hooten says it's more talented than last year's regular season champion, but they're collectively talented. It's not an isolation team where guys need to dribble from the perimeter.
Right, and you know, you see a mistake like that in Terriante. That's the second time that that's happened to him tonight. You know, those are just little things that need to be cleaned up. But you're right, the talent on this team collectively is impressive.
Three turnovers in the first half for the Cats. They've had four already since halftime. Colin Cooper back in the game, played a few minutes in the first half. Cross court, Cooper somehow kept a pivot foot on the ground. Baker for three, short. And a foul underneath. Furlong battling with Koval. Now Bearcats, five team fouls. Central Arkansas nearing the bonus. Jones with the foul. Went for the steal against Jones.
And Dewan Jones, he saw that loose ball and wanted to go for it and was trying to get to it.
Offensive foul. Chatham a moving screen. Smith inbounds to Dewan Jones. Jones out of Columbus, Mississippi. Jones from the left wing. Right there. I misspoke, of course. He's from Killeen, Texas. Offensive foul. Cooper Jones, the Killeen man, draws the charge. Central Arkansas had it to single digits. Bearcats back up 10 at the media timeout. Now welcome back, a physical second half. Both teams with six team fouls committed in just over 8 minutes. So free throws will be a key here in the second half. Dane and Swoop will inbound. And to DeJuan Jones. Jones out of Ellison High School in Killeen. His role growing and growing as the season goes along. Just hit an important three for the Cats. Now he gets in the lane, out to RJ Smith. Another three for Sam Houston State.
What a great pass by DeJuan Jones to an open RJ Smith for a three-pointer.
It's a 6-0 run for Sam Houston State. And there is a travel in front of the Central Arkansas bench. Aaron Widenar returns out of Bozeman, Montana. Smith, another three off the back rim. Widenar with the rebound. Jones, Chatham, good footwork in the paint to avoid the travel and score the left-handed layup. Jones sprinting ahead. What a confident player, DeJuan Jones, right now. Furlong missed the 15-footer. Good fight for Smith to keep it alive. It's Bearcat basketball. Ryan Bergerson will return.
Bubba Furlong getting some extended minutes with both Tikanico and Mitchell having three fouls.
And Jones and Bergerson have combined for 4 points tonight for Central Arkansas. On average, they combine for 29. 15 for Bergerson, 14 for Jones. The Bearcats have shut them down. Here's Jones. The corner for Nuttall. Well contested by Koval, one of the best shot blockers in the country. Bergerson. Jones, Kyalud, left hand, missed it. Central Arkansas ball.
Kyalud had a wide open lane to come into, tried to float it in there and it just popped back out of the rim.
Kyalud playing with three fouls. As a travel from Chatham. Turnover is suddenly a concern for Central Arkansas. Now 8 in the second half, 18 for the game. We had that high-flying first half. It's 13-11 Central Arkansas since the break. Swoop off a screen, just rolled off. Koval fights for the rebound. I don't know how that did not go in. Jones, great anticipation. He anticipated the lob, got in the air to block the pass from Jones. Then he takes the three, it's off the back rim. DeAndre Jones with the rebound for the Bears. Inside to Koval, Furlong read it well for the steal. Out to Swoop, 2-on-2 for the Cats. Swoop, great awareness from a grad transfer to pull that out.
Yeah, double team, didn't have a shot, didn't have anybody following him.
Up by 11.
Yep.
Use the clock to your advantage. Furlong. Not all. Missed it. One-handed put back from Smith. That was spectacular.
Nice job by RJ Smith to position himself well to be in the lane to get that put back.
Foul in transition. Danen Swoop with the block. Chatham. We'll go to the free throw line with the Bears in the bonus. Smith and Furlong depart. Cyrus Johnson and Kai Mitchell return for Sam Houston State.
First time we've seen Kai Mitchell in quite a while, so it'd be important for him to stay out of the foul trouble. But I think they need his offensive production.
Chatham misses the front end of a 1-1. Big miss there for the Bears. Jones getting an extended run here. Just missed it. Mitchell taps the rebound to Swoop. Back to Jones. He calls out the play as he stands on the Bearcat logo. Nuttall draws the foul on Chatham. 1-1 coming for Nuttall. Second foul on Chatham. Xavier Bryant return. Nice spell from DeJuan Jones.
We talk about DeJuan Jones coming in a ball game and making an impact. He's just done all the things that a coach would ask for.
Nuttall misses the front end of the 1-1. DeAndre Jones for Central Arkansas. Bergerson to the corner. In and out. Foul underneath. Will go against SK Shitsu.
Like there was a push off as he was positioning himself for the rebound.
Now Shitsu, a very hard worker in the eyes of the head coach Anthony Boone. Had a big scare as a freshman, a heart arrhythmia. Coach Boone said he may have died if not for a teammate getting there, recognizing it. Calling the trainer over, very traumatic. A haunting experience, but still working hard on the court and in the classroom. That all makes both, 14 points for the sophomore. Inbounded to Baker, back to DeAndre Jones. Fifteen-point lead for the Cats. Bergerson looks frustrated. He cannot get open for shots. Kyalu bursting forward off the glass. Eddie Kyalu, just a sophomore. He might have a bright future in Central Arkansas with his physicality and skill set.
Yeah, tremendous upside for him, especially as he gets to be in a program a little bit longer.
Mitchell, Swoop. Back to Mitchell, 8 to shoot. He'll try another three, and got it. 26 for Kai Mitchell today. Mitchell, 10 of 13 from the field, 3 of 4 from downtown.
Just having a tremendous game. When he's in, he is hot.
And so is Eddie Kyalute from the opposite corner. That's his first three, but he's got 13 points today on 12 shots and limited playing time due to foul trouble. Kai Mitchell, you would not think by his three threes today, as Kyalute bursts forward, blocking foul on Cyrus Johnson. That's a critical call because Kyalute playing with three fouls, and he seems like he wants to will the Bears back into this game.
He really does. The level of play that he's at right now, his energy.
Media timeout here in Huntsville. The Bearcats maintaining a 13-point lead. How you holding up? He's awesome. Kai Mitchell leading the Bearcats today, 26 points, a career high, 3 made three-pointers. He's 3 for 4 from deep. 26 points in 20 minutes. You wonder what if he didn't get into foul trouble. Now Kyalute misses the first.
Well, if he could stay clean for the next couple minutes without any fouls, he may can continue to contribute.
Now Ryan Bergerson on the bench, down by 12 points, the leading scorer on the bench. He's had a quiet day today, 2 points, 1 of 5 from the field for Central Arkansas. Mitchell, good pass to find Swoop. At the fifth or sixth time today that they've shuffled the feet, kind of a smirk from Swoop, but it's one of those where you have to adjust to the way the officials are calling the game.
They're calling it, no doubt, on both sides. It's not favored to one team or the other.
Jones, top of the key, Koval. Swoop got a hand on it, intended for Widener in the corner.
Widener was going to have a pretty good look right there. I don't know if he would have taken the three, so a good tip by Swoop.
Tipped away from Jones, another turnover for Central Arkansas. Widener did not seem too confident with that inbounds pass, but he comes back, knocks it away from Mitchell. He missed it. Bryant flying for the save. What a rebound from Bryant. He somehow stayed in bounds.
He came flying out of nowhere, saved that ball, and hit it back to Kai Mitchell. Keep the possession alive.
And that finish from Zach Nuttall. 16 for Nuttall. Koval, top of the key. Koval's been quiet in the second half. 20 in the first half. Those are his first two of the second. A dunk from the seven-footer.
Just heard somebody behind me say that was just a layup for him, not really.
Smith closed out by Kyalu. Bryan hands off for Swoop. Back to Smith. Nuttall with Mitchell. Mitchell draws a double team. Picks out Swoop. Touch pass Nuttall. Nuttall plus the foul. He had to beat two, Widener and Koval. And this is Sam Houston offense at its best, moving the ball on the perimeter and then attacking as a team.
Well, you know, Zach Nuttall's really kind of has a quiet game so far, but now he's coming out in the second half and doing some explosive things and drawing the attention. Kai Mitchell had our attention in the first half. Now it's Zach Nuttall's turn.
Baker goes to the bench after his third foul. Bergerson returns. Three-point play for Zach Nuttall. He has 19 today. Double-double for Nuttall on Wednesday against Southeastern Louisiana. Bergerson. Kyler with the flyby. Feed for Koval, knocked away by the Cats. Smith for Nuttall. Bryant into Mitchell for two. And Hooten pointed to his head, I think thinking smart play and manage what's now a 17-point lead. Jones misses the three. Offensive rebound, Koval. Jones to the corner, Widener. Got it. Widener, 3 for 3 from deep. An effective 9 points off the bench. Media timeout here in Huntsville. The Cats up 15, closing in another Southland Conference win. .418 left here in the second half. Kai Mitchell having some fun with one of the cameras a moment ago, showing the Sam Houston logo before the inbound from Swoop. Here's Mitchell over midcourt. Central Arkansas likely going to start trapping or even fouling here. Xavier Bryant with the reverse layup. His first 2 points today.
Great job by Xavier Bryant to see what they were trying to do and just go drive the lane.
Corner three, missed by Bergerson. Just not his day today. Runs out to Nuttall. Nuttall sizes up Jones. Blocked by Bergerson. Great closeout from Central Arkansas's leading scorer. Kyalute inside. Nice touch with the left hand. He's got 16. Now Bergerson had that block. His dad, Roberto, drafted by the Atlanta Hawks. 90-99 draft. Finish from Xavier Bryant. Roberto Bergerson in the Boise State Hall of Fame. His mom, Rhonda, played soccer at University of Washington. Koval from the left wing, missed it. And a foul underneath, a push off. Xavier Bryant into the back of Widener. Third foul on Bryant. Another media timeout. Cats up 17 over Central Arkansas. .312 left in the second half. Widener to the free throw line. Bearcats trying for the men and women sweep. The Bearcat women's basketball team, they beat Central Arkansas earlier today. Stay a half game back of Stephen F. Austin. 73-58 win, a dominant fourth quarter. Raven Justice's team outscored the Sugar Bears 25-6 in the fourth. Bearcats break the press. Back for Xavier Bryant. Coach Hooten really giving everyone an opportunity to play guard today. Chad Bowie, the starter. Bryant, Jones, good minutes off the bench. Nuttall misses the three. Kyalu with the rebound. But I think the offense stagnated. Bowie went to the bench, and then Jones and Bryant have revived it. Baker from the corner. His first made three today. Central Arkansas now. 6 of 22 from deep. But it shows with Jason Hooten, he has his starters, but he'll make adjustments in game, and in the second half, largely went with DeJuan Jones and Bryant.
Right, he has some weapons on the bench. And then the great thing about the offense, depending on whose night it is, tonight it's been Kai Mitchell. It may be a Zach Nuttall night, maybe a Dan and Swoop night.
Chad Bowie played 17 minutes in the first half. He's played 6 minutes in the second. And in total, you got 30 minutes for Nuttall, 11 for Bryant, 9 for DeJuan Jones, 23 for Bowie. Really spacing out the minutes for the guards.
Right. Kai Mitchell, very good free throw shooter, shooting about right at 80% on the season. Has a nice touch. Kind of goes along with his mid-range jumper.
Mitchell makes both. 30 points for Kai Mitchell.
Yeah.
And then Koval called for the foul.
Juan Jones ran into a moving wall named Koval.
Nuttall into Smith. Hand it off for Nuttall. Bryant directing traffic. Dayton Swoop. Whistle called. Lewis McDaniel just into the game, a freshman from Nashville, Tennessee. His first minutes for Central Arkansas today. Nuttall back to the line, 19 points today. Nuttall, 18 points, 11 rebounds, both a game high on Wednesday in the win at Southeastern Louisiana.
Zach Nuttall was coming through the lane, got tripped up, kind of favoring his right lower leg or knee.
Now Chad Bowie returns for Zach Nuttall. Now the Bearcats taking nothing for granted, up 16, pressing with 1:44 left. Thrown out to Kyalute, step back three, missed it. Mitchell tried to save the rebound. The Bearcats were contending that Baker, while he ran the line, lost the ball. And that should be a illegal play, dribbling while he tried to inbound it. He may have kept it in his hands.
A little bit of a conference going on here.
Here's Cooper. High screen from SK Shitu. Back to Shitu. Baker for three. Tapped by Mitchell. He brings it down. Here's Swoop. Now Baker's got some size. Redshirt freshman. He's also a nice prospect for this team. He's got great range and nice shooting form.
He does, and he can stretch it out to beyond the arc as well. Nice touch.
1 minute left in Huntsville. Shot clock at 8 for DeJuan Jones. Corner three for Smith. Rims out. Mitchell nearly with another rebound.
Nice look by RJ Smith, just in and out.
30 points, 8 boards for Kai Mitchell today. Mitchell knocked it away. And a turnover, Cooper rushed the pass to the corner. His intended target was Masai Oluwokere out of Brooklyn. And RJ Smith, handed off to Juan Jones. 5 second difference between the clocks. Jones blocked in the backcourt by Colin Cooper. Bubba Furlong, Osiris Johnson return. Johnson sent a former NBA player, Marquez Johnson. 14 years in the NBA, the Bucks, the Clippers, the Warriors. Third overall pick out of UCLA. And Johnson now a TV analyst for the Milwaukee Bucks. DeMarcus Lampley also returns. Now the Bearcats. In control from start to finish today. Jones makes the second. And I really wonder, this year's team compared to last year's team, you don't want to say that last year's team peaked too early, but they had the perfect start to the season and had the double bye, had to wait to get the conference tournament started. This year's team had the three-game losing streak a moment ago. They lost two of three earlier. But if they could carry this victory into the final five games, have a little more momentum going into the tournament, it might help them out.
I think you are right. I mean, I think they did peak too early last year, and what it did, they had a good team. Obviously, they won the conference championship, but didn't do well in the tournament. This team is still getting better.
Yes.
And so it's, just continuing to improve night in and night out, going through a stretch like that where you're getting challenged. I think they needed that. They need that to kind of gel together and figure out some things. Identify where some weaknesses are to work on those. But this team is still getting better. And some of the auxiliary pieces are starting to contribute more now as well. And I think that's going to suit them well for tournament time.
Furlong fouls Cooper. Cooper will go to the free throw line. 1 second left here in Huntsville.
Furlong got up in the air. Your feet on are on the ground. They're going to call a foul on you if you make body contact.
Bearcats win by 15. Open up a two-game lead over Central Arkansas in the Southland. Sam Houston State now 10-5 in Southland Conference play. Your thoughts, Ken Holland?
Well, two things. I think the Bearcats needed to come back home up after a tough road trip, get a good win here to kind of set them up for the remaining part of the season. This Central Arkansas team, they're still sitting in a spot where they can get into the tournament. They're growing and developing and getting better as well. It's going to be fun to watch them down the stretches and see what they can do into the tournament.
Kai Mitchell, 30 points here tonight. A career high for the senior. We'll come back after a short break with the head coach, Jason Hooten. Welcome back, Johnson Coliseum, a celebratory atmosphere. Bearcats win by 15 over Central Arkansas. Now joined by the head coach, Jason Hooten. All right, coach, another win for your team. And I think it starts on the defensive end. These teams scored 89 against you in Conway about a month ago. You hold them to 67. What changed today?
Well, I told our guys I thought today's game would basically come down to defending and rebounding. And I haven't looked at the final rebounding totals, but I know at halftime we had a 5-rebound lead, and I thought our defense was good all day long. They're a really good team. They're very well coached, and they can really shoot. And I thought our guys were ready to play today, and they executed the game plan perfectly.
Bergerson and DeAndre Jones, two of the stars, they typically combine for about 29 points per game. They were limited a total of 4 points between those two. What'd you do specifically against Bergerson and Jones?
You know, they were a focal point, obviously. They're two of the better players in the league, top 10 players probably in the league on the same team. And our guys were ready to play. You know, Coach Mudge did a great job of having the scouting report ready. And I thought we took away a lot of things they like to do. And you got to give our guys credit because, you know, it's a team game, obviously, but there's a couple of individuals who I thought stepped up defensively today. Maybe Zach Nuttall's best defensive game as a sophomore. And, you know, and what can you say about Chad? I mean, Chad's been one of our best defenders the last 2 years. And I thought those two guys, you know, they took the lead on that for sure.
Kai Mitchell, not often you can say he was in foul trouble and he also had a career high, but that's the case for Kai Mitchell today. He was awesome in the first half, limited in the second half due to foul trouble, but still a career high and starting to become a three-point shooter as well.
Well, there's not a lot of things I can't say bad about Kai. You know, he'll be a guy that when the end of the year comes, there'll be a lot of tears shed by me. You know, those are guys are special. They don't come along very often. Today's his birthday.
Wow, didn't know that.
He played really well today, and I'm going to try to get his birthday to be about 5, 6, 7, 8 more times this year.
Well, a big win for your team. You come off the 3-game road swing. You win on Wednesday in Hammond. You win this game here today. What about the rest of the season and these final 5 games, and what do you take from this game into the last 5?
We told our guys at Southeastern it's a 7-game season, and we're 2-0, so we got 5 games left, and we're just going to take them one at a time. Going to take tomorrow off. We're going to really enjoy this one because we beat a good team tonight, and I thought we played pretty well tonight. We played a little bit more tonight, like against Louisiana Tech and against Abilene Christian here and Corpus. We played our game tonight because if you look at the box, we only made 6 threes and we scored 82 points, and that's when we're playing our best. And I think what we're doing is starting to move the ball better like last year.
All right, Coach. Well, we'll let you go celebrate this one. Kai Mitchell will join us in a moment. So thanks again for your time.
All right. Thank you. Appreciate it.
That's head coach Jason Hooten. And the birthday boy will join us momentarily. A birthday and a career high 30 points for Kai Mitchell, who was beset at times by foul trouble, but his teammates did enough to keep it close and extend that lead. So first off, happy birthday.
Thank
and
you.
Did you wake up this morning thinking you might want to have an extra special performance? It's your senior season, your last birthday as a college player. Did that have any factor on it?
Oh, of course. And you know, a main thing was we had went to Central Arkansas and lost the last outing, so it wasn't really hard to get up and play for this game at all.
We were looking through your three-point numbers. You seem pretty selective. Last 3 games didn't even try a three. Today you hit your first. Talk about your evolution now as a three-point shooter.
You know, I'm just taking what the defense is giving to me. I work real hard on my jump shot, you know, and I'm confident in it, and it was just open tonight.
I asked Coach Hooten, but how about the guard play defensively? Bergerson, DeAndre Jones, two very good players, averaging around 15 points per game each, and your guard shut them down. How about the defensive effort from
team? That was big time from Chad, Danen, Xavier, DeJuan, all the way down the board. You know, we game planned on them guys, and they executed.
You were on last year's team, the regular season champion, a disappointing South End Conference tournament. What's different about this year's team here with 5 games left?
This year, we got a lot more to prove. We've been losing. You know, we had a 3-game losing streak at one point in the season, and we're just now getting back on it. But everybody has a target on our back since we won last year. So it's kind of tough, but we're up for the challenge.
You had over 20 points in the first half, but had to sit a lot in the second. Was it difficult to sit down in foul trouble knowing you were having a career afternoon?
Yeah, it was. But, you know, my teammates picked me up, and it worked out all in the end.
All right, Kai, happy birthday. Congratulations. A career high 30 points, including three-pointers.
Thank you. Appreciate you.
That's Kai Mitchell, part of the victorious Sam Houston State Bearcats. That will do it here from Johnson Coliseum. The Bearcats sweep the Bears. Women and men both get it done. Thank you to Ken Holland and our entire crew. My name is Matt Peterson, saying so long from Huntsville, Texas. Final score, Sam Houston State 82, Central Arkansas 67. All games are available via Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN.